fight a little different for you? Because is it almost like an audition? Because I know you have some big fights possibly ahead. So do you look at this fight a little different, like maybe an audition to show people, showcase again who Danny Garcia is, to remind everybody?
I wouldn't say it's an audition, but I would say it's definitely a very important fight for me. This is a very important fight for me, for my future. And you know, my future starts on Saturday night for all the big fights. You know, I've already been in a lot of big fights in my career. I fought 13 world champions. I've been in 10 world title fights. So it's not new to me. I know Red Catch is hungry, but I know what it takes to win at this level, and I'm ready.
Is it add a little comfort that you're in Barclays, which is like your home away from home, if you always claim?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like I have unfinished business here. You know, this is my house, and I feel like I have unfinished business here, so I plan on making a statement.
Any message for the haters or the doubters out there, Danny?
Oh, no, man. If you love me, you love me. If you hate me, you hate me. Just keep watching me. That's it.
All right, good luck to you.
Hey, Danny, you know, welcome back to your second home, of course. Have you done anything different in training camp? You seem very happy inside the ring. You're smiling a lot. It looks like you're enjoying yourself, you know?
Yeah, well, you know, I fell in love. You know, you gotta understand, I've been boxing for 21 years. You know, I've been boxing since I was 10 years old, so all the big fights and all the pressure over your career, sometimes you get tired of it. You know, sometimes you get tired of it. And sometimes it takes something to wake you back up. You know, I'm 31 years old, I feel good, I feel young. And I would say that, you know, I fell in love with the sport of boxing again. Put it that way.
What woke you back up?
You know, it was just, you gotta understand, I've been fighting at the championship level since 2012 when I first won both my world titles. I held my 140-pound titles from 2012 to 2016. Then I moved up and held the titles from 16 to 18 when I fought Thurman. So there's a lot of pressure, and when people expect a lot from you, sometimes you forget what makes you happy in the sport of boxing. So you lose the love for the sport, you know, because so much pressure, and it becomes a business. So it's like you're not having fun no more. And I noticed that this is what makes me happy. When I don't fight and I'm sitting home, I just don't feel happy. So, you know, I just started counting my blessings.
Need a rest, maybe?
Yeah, maybe that's what it was. Yeah. Maybe that's what it was. Mentally, I probably just needed some time to just let my head breathe. And just, you know, just fall in love with it. You know, I love it. I felt good. Like my last camp, the Granado fight, I felt good. I felt happy. This camp, I feel happy. I'm in a point in my career, I've been through it all already. So I have no choice but to be happy and count my blessings. Go out there and give my fans a great fight.
Now, Danny, I just have to speak. When you picked Ivan, it was a very good choice because of softball.
Yes, sir.
It was a third softball or a switch hitter. I had a conversation with Terrence Crawford a couple of weeks ago. He acknowledged that you're high ranking in the WBO. I told him you were number one. He encouraged and allowed the WBO to say mandate the fight I would like. He said it was a good storyline. You guys fought in the amateurs. He didn't speak anything negative, but he said he would like that fight. If they mandate you in that, would you be interested in facing Crawford?
Yeah, I believe I'm ranked number one WBC, WBA, and WBO.
Yep, so we got a lot.
The ball's in my court. But, yeah, for sure. Like I said before, this is a business. And this is a business. And anything can be made if it's just done right. There's really not much to say. I mean, we fought for free.
So, again, it's on a Saturday statement.
Yeah, we want the big fight, for sure. We want the big fight. I have to worry about Red Cash right now. I can't overlook him. And I have to go in there and nominate him. And then the sky's the limit after that. I think any fight can be made.
Hey, Danny.
Do you feel like fighters calling out UFC fighters, like Conor McGregor, obviously, his name is mentioned a lot.
Yeah, well, he's a superstar.
Right.
You know, anytime you're a superstar, your name makes headlines. Everyone's going to call you out because if it don't work, it still gave you some money. So it's a win-win.
Danny, what do you think of that fight, McGregor and Pacquiao? Do you think it ever come into fruition? And if it did, how would you see it playing out?
I can see him coming true because Manny Pacquiao is a global icon and Conor McGregor is a big superstar and it'll generate a lot of money. And for that reason, I can see it happening.
What do you think of McGregor as a boxer?
It didn't look that bad against Mayweather for his first fight. First pro debut fighting a legend. Yeah. You know, he went 9 rounds with him. That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
Hey, Danny, get back on your fight here. Ivan was talking a lot in the back how he wants to close the show early. He's got a big surprise for you. He wants to meet you right in the center of the ring. Are you willing to do that, or are you going to try to acquire some rounds in here?
Well, I'm the bigger, stronger guy, so if he does that, he's in trouble. But we're ready for whatever. We trained, we banged it out in sparring, we boxed in sparring. And as a true champion, you gotta go in there and make adjustments. It could be an easy night, or we might have to dig deep. We're ready for whatever.
Now, awesome. Two more questions.
Now, Danny, obviously, I think a lot of people are asking questions outside of your opponent because they assume that you're the favorite. I'm gonna ask one out as well. Arrow obviously had an accident. I know that you want to fight because he has a unit fight. Do you think he should have a tune-up before facing you because of the uncertainty and unknowns? Because coming and facing someone like you, that's a big step up.
Yeah, for sure. I am a dangerous fighter to go right into because I'm a big hitter with both hands, so I'm a dangerous fighter for anybody. Only he knows. If he feels like he's ready, then he's ready. If he's not, then he's not. Only he knows. Maybe that's the question. Maybe you have to ask. You gotta ask him.
Danny, last question. Danny, how do you see Wilder 2 playing out?
I think it's gonna be something like the first fight. It's gonna be a technical bout. But if Wilder lands that punch, it's over. But I think it's gonna be the same type of fight as the first fight.
Prediction for your fight, Saturday night.
You know, I'm going for the KO. I'm going to see the KO under 9 rounds.
Next fight paper.